Hey guys, how are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, you might be aware of the fact that we also have a series, the name of which is Let's Solve Some Questions for Prelims 2020. So as is clear from its name, this series is about about solving questions relating to your prelims. But let me clarify you that it is not just about solving the questions, but it is also about your participation. So we expect that you people participate in the discussion by comment by posting your comments in the comment box, and you can share additional information with us there in addition to the explanations that are provided by us. And also, if you have any doubts, queries, you can ask in the comment box. So we will promptly revert back to your doubts. So today is video number 14. So we will be discussing today the questions of geography. So let's see what the questions. First is, why are tsunamis relatively rare in Indian Ocean as compared to the Pacific Ocean? First, average wave height in Indian Ocean is shorter than in Pacific Ocean. Second, seismic activity is less as compared to the Pacific. So which of the above is are correct? Let me tell you friends that first cannot be the answer, because average wave height has nothing to do with tsunami. So it is a seismic activity which results in the tsunami. So the answer is second, that is B, second only. So you might be aware of the fact that tsunamis also not just take place due to seismic activity, but also volcanic eruptions, or for example landslide, or meteoritic impact in the ocean. And then while the earthquake cannot be predicted in advance, but advanced warnings can be given. So such advanced warnings are there in the Indian Ocean because seismic activity here is relatively low. So now let's move to the next question. Next is, neap low tides occur when A, sun, moon and earth are in the same line; B, sun, moon and earth form a circle; C, sun, moon and earth form a right angle triangle; D, earth is centered between sun and moon. So friends, let me tell you that first is wrong, because sun, moon and earth, when they are in same line, then what is created is a neap tide. So it is not neap tide, it is basically high tide. Sorry for the mistake. And B cannot be possible, circle cannot be formed, and D can also be not possible, because earth is not centered between sun and moon. Earth can be in between sun and moon, but please note here the word, the minute, the subtle word, that is centered. So D cannot be the answer. So answer is C, that is sun, moon and earth form a right angle triangle. So when all are in the same line, high tide, that is spring tide, tides are formed. So option A is wrong, and also B and C do not lead to low neap tides. Moreover, it is not possible for earth to be centered between sun and moon, so it must be here D, not B. So option solution is C. So the strong gravitational pull exerted by the sun and the moon on the earth's surface causes tides. So sun as well as moon generates gravitational pull, due to which water level rises. So water of the earth closer to the moon gets pulled under the influence of moon's gravitational force and causes high tide. So during the full moon and new moon days, the sun and moon and earth are in the same line. So and the tides are highest. So these tides are called spring tides. So when the moon is in its first and last quarter, the ocean waters get drawn in diagonally opposite directions, because the gravitational pull is from two sides, that is gravitational pull of sun, and then also gravitational pull by the moon. So these tides are called neap tide. So here you can see, so this is neap tide, so this is sun, this is moon. So kind of water is the gravitational pull is divorced. So when they are in the same line, so then this high tide takes place. So please note that word, when they are in the same line, then that could be that leads to the spring tide, that is high tide. So neap tide is when earth, moon and sun are at right angle triangle. So here you can also see that earth is not centered, so it is more towards moon, because obviously the distance between sun earth and moon is insignificant when compared to sun. So now let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following: first, foggy weather; second, high biological productivity; C, plentiful fish catch. So the above are associated with which of the following? A, intertidal zones; B, meeting of warm and cold current; C, marine upwelling zones; D, shallow seas. So friends, the answer is B, that is meeting of warm and cold currents. So foggy weather, high biological productivity and plentiful fish catch takes place when the warm and cold currents meet. So at the meeting point, foggy weather is created. So intertidal zones are regions where high tide and low tide are regions between high tide and low tide area. So they are biologically productive, but foggy weather is not experienced there. So, and then marine upwelling zones are rich in nutrients, as nutrient rich water is upwelled to come to the top, but again foggy weather is not experienced there. So option C is wrong. So learning is that areas where warm and cold currents meet tend to have regular foggy conditions, as the overlying warm and cold air come in contact with each other. So they also have high biological productivity because of the plankton growth. It is encouraged by the mixing of warm and cold currents because a kind of congenial environment is available there. So some of the world's most productive fishing grounds are located where warm and cold currents converge. So for example, Labrador Current and Gulf Stream, where they meet, a dense fog is there, and it is one of the richest fishing grounds of the world. Now let's move to the next question. Next is Ladakh, a cold desert in Greater Himalayas, is enclosed by A. Karakoram Range in north and Jaskar Range in the south. B. Jaskar Range in the north and Karakoram Range in south. C. Peer Panjal Range in north and Jaskar Range in south. D. Karakoram Range in north and Peer Panjal Range in south. So we have to choose the answer. So let me tell you friends, the answer is A. So here you can see this is Karakoram Range. So after Karakoram Range, this comes Ladakh Cold Desert, and then this comes your Jaskar Range. So if you know that Peer Panjal is further south, so then obviously you can easily choose option A, because Peer Panjal is in the south. So Karakoram is at the top, and then here comes Jaskar and Peer Panjal. So Karakoram, Ladakh, Jaskar, Peer Panjal. So please note this word, either remember it by cramming or it by anything, but please remember this. This is very important. Now let's move to the next question. Sorry, here is a number mistake. So it is fifth question. In the season of retreating monsoon, wind blows from Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal towards the Indian land. B. The Indian mainland towards Bay of Bengal and Southeast India. C. The Indian mainland towards Southwest India. D. Southeast India to Western Indian mainland. So the friends, the answer is B, that is Indian mainland towards Bay of Bengal and Southeast India. So when the season of there is of retreating monsoon, that is when winter starts setting in, the wind starts blowing from Bay of Bengal, blowing from mainland to the Bay of Bengal and towards the Southeast India. So this retreating monsoon brings also rainfall in, if you might be aware of the fact, in the state of Tamil Nadu. So answer is B. So the learning is that during onset and advance of monsoon, winds blow from Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal towards the land, and they carry moisture with them, and when these winds strike the mountain barriers, rainfall occurs. So during the season of retreating monsoon, winds move back from the mainland to the Bay of Bengal. So southern parts of India, particularly Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh, receive rainfall in this season. So these are 5 questions of today. So if you have scored 5 out of 5 or your score is above 3 or 3, then it is good. But if you have scored 0, 1, 2, then it is very much good. Because I would say that you have learned something today. Because ultimately, friends, what will matter is your gradual progress towards your goal. So if you start judging yourself very first day and will start counting your score, then how will you improve? How will you cover the topics? So you can see that while discussing these MCQs, you have learned something. At least you have become aware of some facts and concepts. So that could benefit you in your prelims or in your real-time exam. So don't count your scores the very first day. The purpose of this is that obviously you have to improve yourself, and improvement only comes when you read or when you go through the concepts. And if you stop seeing these videos just because of the fear of low score, then ultimately that would cost you people only, because those who will watch it daily will be able to revise more concepts. So please ensure that you don't lag behind. So this was the discussion. So friends, also we have various series, as I have told you earlier, on our channel that we are running. So you can also, we have geography NCERT series, we have history NCERT series, polity NCERT series, and then we have MCQ series based on M. Lakshmikant, and then MCQ series based on spectrum. So all these series are available on our platform. So the link of these series is there in the description box. So those students, mostly students, are preparing from home and they are lacking the self-discipline that must be there, the time-bound framework in which they must prepare their syllabus. So for to do it, we have decided that we will what we will do, we will kind of provide daily provide the students daily targets following which they will be able to complete their syllabus on time. So if in case you are interested to join, then do ensure that you check the description box, because all the links are there. So also you can join us on Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen, and this is also available in description box. So here on this Telegram channel, we have more than 15,000 students that follow us, and they have access to various public resources that we have for the purpose of CSE preparation. So if in case you want to gain access to those public resources, then you are more than welcome to join our Telegram channel, and link is available down in the description box. So this is all about today's video. Do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you friends, have a very nice day ahead.